Echoes of change reverberate across rural Asia. In Taiwan, youths are returning to their hometowns to rediscover forgotten traditions. They're revitalizing old trades and empowering entire communities.
光是吊船就是一个人就把一个礼拜就吊一顿同一种鱼，那价格就会下得很严重。蕉农可以当一个rocker，他也不一定是只有在种香蕉。来，金姐给两个，试吃看麦，哎，试吃看麦这盘去，香蕉蛋糕。 要试试看吗？谢谢。哦，谢谢。来，哎，岐山第一家做香蕉蛋糕就是我们。来试试看，我们是台青椒。This
is one of Taiwan's most popular tourist destinations. Over 6 million visitors thronged Qishan's old streets in 2023. Many of them are here to have a taste of its history through its famous banana treats.
好吃吗？好吃，好吃，谢谢。 你下次可以来我们香蕉园玩哦，我们还有一个香蕉园，就是亲子可以有一些活动来体验，对，可以来采香蕉哦，好不好？Just
15 years ago, all these shops selling banana products didn't exist. A band of young rockers kick-started the trend. They hail from the district of Qishan, on the outskirts of Kaohsiung. When they're not rocking out, they're working on their organic banana farm. Ji Wei and He Huen are new generation farmers who only use organic and regenerative farming methods, prioritizing soil health, biodiversity, and environmental sustainability.
像这个头很大，屁股很大，头很小的这种香蕉，啊，选定这种香蕉，我们就会移植。 这个就是香蕉繁衍后代的一种方式。那香蕉是不靠种子，它可以用西亚，就像竹笋一样。With
its warm climate, abundant rainfall, and fertile soil, Qishan, once known as the Banana Kingdom, is ideal for growing these trees. For generations, they've provided a major source of income for the locals.
老一辈九八十、九十岁，他们就说香蕉是他们的荣耀。 因为那个是他们经历过人生最辉煌的日子，因为种香蕉，他们成家立业、买房，哦，然后买地，它是一个他们人生成功的那一个途径。那个对他们来讲是神主牌啊。During
their colonial rule of Taiwan, the Japanese started to import bananas from the colony. Even after pulling out of the territory, they continued to do so. And the numbers reached a peak in the early 1960s, when 90% of bananas consumed in Japan were imported from southern Taiwan. The trade had made tycoons of many Qishan farmers.
早年老人家有一句话就是，九份是卖金的哈，啊，岐山也是卖金的。比如说他们会换算单位，老师一个月的薪水等于两串香蕉。
But in the late 1960s, Qishan's banana industry crashed as Japan began to source the fruit from countries like the Philippines. Local economy has been in the doldrums since. Those who could leave Qishan left.
我们是1983的孩子，所以那个时候台湾其实就开始是城乡要移到都市的这个历程。哦，那家长开始也觉得地方已经没有机会，就岐山人戏称，就是那时候大概岐山人走了三分之一，哦，因为那时候有钱嘛，所以都还可以走。像我有一些同学哦，现在打开脸书，又看到他们在世界各地，就是哦有阿根廷的啦、南非的啦，也是那个时候移民。
Today, Qishan's population has fallen to under 35,000. A quarter of them are over the age of 65. Ji Wei himself drifted north to the cities to study, but his heart remained, and the plan was to come back to remake Qishan. Like its agriculture industry, Taiwan's fisheries are also finding it hard to attract young talents. It's 4 a.m. in the morning, and Xiao Tong has just begun her workday. Since graduating from the university 2 years ago, this has been her daily routine. She's spent most of her life here in Tochang, a small town of 28,000 that sits along the Pacific Ocean and has a strong fishing tradition. Although only 24, Xiao Tong is an old hand at preparing and selling fresh seafood, having watched her parents toil in the trade day in and out. Even for someone so young, it's back-breaking work.
脚会痛，脚会超酸的。回家就一定要抬腿，不然脚腿真的超痛，通通睡不着那种。不然就是手肘，因为现在学鲨鱼之后，手腕或者是切大鱼，因为今天的鱼都就是胸口也会痛，然后手臂也会痛。变成说你出力的时候，就是胸口也会痛，然后手臂也会痛。变成说，女生手力又不够，以前妈妈是教用这里去瞪那个刀子，以前是你知道，妈妈现在你自己已经长茧，我以前这里没长茧，蹬下去那个手好像快要断掉一样。
Xiao Tong's day doesn't end here. At 11, she drives for an hour to the port to wait for fishing boats to come back with the day's catch. This is where she gets her supply for the next day.
其实也没有说一定要一定不要，就是你看了你觉得明天可能需要用你就买，因为明天没什么，所以就可能价钱买一些明天卖，是吧？就是你也不能都不买，要不然明天就卖不了，所以就是看了好像长得还不错，价钱还OK就可以买。年轻比较长会觉得我们是屁孩，就是他们会觉得我们好像都不懂，然后价钱也都会随便乱开，就是像我刚才去的话，他们觉得价钱都会开很高。
Tochang's fishing industry is now under threat from severe labor shortages. Young people are unwilling to take over the trade from their parents, who are finding it hard to keep up with the demands of the job. It is rare to find a young woman like Xiao Tong in the business.
除非是真的是那种家里是男生，甚至是男生才会真的继续有比较有大的可能会继续做渔业这个行业，不然基本上都是去外面找工作啊。然后渔船的话，基本上就请外籍义工。But
these days, she feels less alone. ZT, Wen Ting and Wen Chen are Xiao Tong's teammates from Yu Zai Cheng, which means young fish. They created this brand to retail seafood online.
But 然后切这样给他，因为中间这块最好吃，就切这样跟切这样。
应该要拍这只吗？要不要让大家看？
我觉得可以拍的，
这是我们的中
超人，还是你可以再等一下。
Knowing what Xiao Tong has managed to secure at the wholesale market, the rest of the team gets to work quickly to promote the catch through social media and e-commerce platforms.
那你可以再把一些贴到后面。是。好。
OK。大家好，欢迎来到鱼鱼料理小教室。那今天呢，我们要来做的就是酱烧烟台糊。
Members of YouthBanana come from different parts of Taiwan.They had met in the university as business studies students. In year two, they came together to work on a project.
我记得好像是创业的课程，然后老师有提到说什么，要在生活中找问题，然后找出方法解决它。
The unpredictable supply of fish and fluctuating prices are two of the biggest challenges Yilan's fishermen and fishmongers face.Climate change has made the problems worse. Xiao Tong wanted to educate the public on these issues and the sustainable use of marine resources.
Because actually, 虽然说渔获量不大，但是会变成说天气很奇怪，会有单类品种的渔获量暴增。就是光是钓船，就可能一个礼拜就快就钓一吨的鱼，同一种鱼，然后钓一吨，然后变成说销量就是那价格就会下跌很严重。我那时候是烟仔虎爆炸多，然后妈妈因为有收钓船，所以妈妈可能每天就可能要收两三百公斤的烟仔虎，就是没有办法卖出去。啊，为了解决这个问题，才想说去做网络市场，然后让他们知道说，第一时间知道说，哦，现在烟仔虎很便宜，就是你可以去买。哦，对，旁边
大概多少？我可以用鱼仔信的发文吗？
当然可以，当然可以。OK 的。
那我们来办个抽奖吧。
要抽什么？要抽谁？
抽这个十块钱。
抽。
猜对我们煮什么的。
What began as a school project turned into a real business venture in 2022, when Yutsai Ching's proposal won seed funding in a contest for budding entrepreneurs. The out-of-towners stayed to make this happen with Xiao Tong, knowing that they won't be drawing a salary anytime soon.
然后我再把这个酱不要浪费。
当初刚提的时候，只是提这个想法而已，因为说没有想到说有人会愿意加入这个，因为这个不是像一般什么网络电商什么，是因为是回归传统产业，就是不知道他们是否愿意，而且他们又不是说真的是住在海边的那种。后来听到他们愿意，我是蛮惊讶。
噔噔噔噔，我的完成了，刚刚有做一些那个技术上的调整。嗯，有没有发现它比较好看一点的呢？
In central Taiwan, another villager inspires others to discover the rustic ingenuity of an architectural style native to his rural hometown.
这个房子哦，可以回推到1934年前。哦，大概八十几年前，一百年前，这个房子大概就不见了。
This traditional tribal home was completed by Chia Shun in 2013 after he returned to Nanfong community in the mountainous Nantou County, known for its beautiful landscapes. It's home to about 1,000 indigenous people from the Seediq tribe.
所以这石头呢，完全没有用任何现代的水泥啊。就是去叠，那二压一，一压二，二压一的方式，所以连叠石这个都要有技术的，要有智慧的。这个家屋当初我们不是做观光旅游，所以一开始是做教育。为什么教育？是我想有一个地方，像我这样的年轻人，什么都不会，母语不会讲，故事听一听也不知道发生在哪里，然后也没有那种空间感，实际状态我也不知道长什么样子。我把它盖出来了，那盖出来的目的是希望以后不要再有像我这样的年轻人。
For decades, not even the elders in the village knew how to build a traditional Seediq home like this from start to finish. It took Tia Shun, whose background is in healthcare management, 4 years of looking through historical documents and interviewing the tribal elders to recover enough knowledge to recreate this stone house and others like it in the community.
This house's owner is about 180 左右的那个高度，所以这个门槛大概就会做到170。那这在防御上呢，它有一个功能，就是这个门哈，挡起来的时候呢，敌人冲进来，他必须要先低头，对不对？所以这边呢，以前打仗的时候哈，会有一个陷阱放在这边，然后这个门哈，推过去的时候会挡住谁？会挡住小朋友，那进来之后呢，这一堵墙呢会挡住妈妈，所以妈妈是睡这个位置。那直接看到门口敌人的是父亲，所以父亲会在这个位置，刀、弓箭都会在这里。
The painstaking process of building the house earned Tia Shun the trust and respect of the villagers, who had seen him more as an outsider. As a child, his parents had sent him to the cities, and he had lost the connection to his roots.A visit to New Zealand as a university student shook him up.
就是2005年，我那一年很清楚，就是原民会办了一个我们大专生青年，就是全台湾很多原民的青年，原住民族的青年呢，有到纽西兰跟毛利人交流的这样的一个机会。那时候其实我坦白讲，我族语不会讲，然后那时候其实连自己是什么族哈都很摇摆，然后我自己是谁很不清楚。
The Seediq.Are one of 16 indigenous tribes in Taiwan. Their total population today is about 10,000, and their language is critically endangered. Aborigines in Taiwan are actually distantly related to the Maori of New Zealand, as part of the broader Austronesian family.
Oh, Maori people, wow, 战舞啊，讲家族的历史，家族的故事，然后我们随行的这些青年。精英啊，原民的青年精英也都可以对自己的部落侃侃而谈，我谈不出来，所以在那时候就想说，我有没有一个机会可以回到自己的部落、自己的家乡，好好了解自己。所以我的动机是这样回来的。
早早起，也着低头起。穿紧少衫去田边，爱雨都滚啊，啊咧田咧啊，啊咧山河啊，啊得来照去。
Formed in 2008, the YouthBanana band comprises Chi Wei, his younger brother Qishan, and two childhood friends, He Yun and Chuan He. Everyone except Chuan He had grown up in Qishan.And were community volunteers since they were very young. Over the years, having seen more people leave town, they've made it their work to bring people back to Qishan. Their biggest project is to revitalize Qishan's once vibrant banana industry.
We at that time just made a plan to do an apple industry. Then we started to experience and find some interviews with apple farmers, and understand the history of apple, and make apple research.那时候就开始做一些香蕉的食品，蛋糕也是其中一个。后面要做一个成果发表，所以我们就想说，那就是可不可以用乐团的方式？啊，因为那个是动态的，如果是静态就不好玩了。哎呀，如果大家只是像很多地方活动，就是大家就是摆出来让大家吃一吃就结束了，但好像少了一些可以讨论的东西啊，因为讨论。音乐当然是一个很重要，就是因为用从听当中才可以开始对话。
山酒冰原好风味，有你有我走田边来饮水，船头水西北风啊真水，日日山西来做面哦。
Youth, passion, catchy tunes, and a good cause.The story of Chi Wei and YouthBanana was a hit with the media. They began to organize music festivals in Qishan to promote their cause, bringing in young visitors new to this part of Taiwan. While in town, these tourists would stop by the Qishan Old Street, looking for banana-flavored cakes.
啊，那时候旗山老街也没有人卖香蕉，连卖鲜果的香蕉都很少。所以其实我们是从消费端着手，就是增加那个公共的互动，因为有钱赚了、啊，哎，客人会来问啊，哎，你怎么没有香蕉？啊、你是面包店，你为什么不做香蕉蛋糕？他们被问以后，哎，就是他们就改变了。这个就是他还是要嗅到商业气息的，可是当然这个不是我们的本意，但这种的改变也会变成是一种新的尝试。
来，帮你上巧克力牛奶。可以，谢谢。
Soon, shops selling all kinds of banana food products mushroomed along Qishan's main commercial street.
有时候变成说，虽然有钱赚了，就变你失去了一些自己的特色。好，比如说像老街就有很多店家是卖泰国的香蕉，啊，这个就不对了，这个就不是我们的本意。还有就是，那你能不能让客人？不要变成说你只是跟他做生意而已，可是他并没有延续在这个地方的那种感受。
To entice sightseers to stay and get to know more about Qishan, YouthBanana has designed immersive tours of the district with a focus on its farms and heritage businesses. Chi Wei wants visitors to discover business opportunities in Qishan.And even consider becoming residents.
Hi, Ai. Hi. 这边是旗山的斗笠店啊，就是编织的店面啊。这边有很多过去都是用手做的方式在做很多的这个传统的一些农具或者是生活用品。来，果贺地区就有很多的这种传统的老店。这一间呢，就是旗山的丰年米店，它很特别，它是有大概将近80年的历史。山林吼，然后旗山原潭这边的种米吼，然后就会到这边来 A V 哦，所以这边都还有保存传统的那个 A V， 就是碾米机。
是咱旗山吼。哎，来佚佗的人拢讲，啊，恁旗山就出山金蕉，恁太无啊，人金蕉，吼，啊，因就当客随意啦，啊，咱就要甲研究，啊，这就是香蕉。
哎，讲到晒米粉哦，我们这边刚好那个溪流会有微气候，会把那个米粉的那个香味就会晒出来。哦，所以这个地方为什么人家会觉得说来了都好啊，也会很有记忆，人家会想要来，其实就跟它的这个发展的纹理有关，所以它会有以前的纹理，让你知道哦，你以前的人还可以回来到现在感受以前啊，现在也可以去感受跟过去的对话。我觉得这个是在这个产业跟这个街区里面想要带给大家的。阿力哥。
欢迎大家来到这次的走读活动。那这一次活动是由我们鱼仔青团队去做主办的。这么多渔港当中，它是一个唯一有拍卖活动的渔港。那这边就是二楼的拍卖市场，然后等一下可以看到拍卖的过程。你帮我走，啊，需要我走，我走啊，下卖，走读是因为发现很多人不认识，因为包括我们团队刚开始建立的时候带他们来，我才发现说哦，原来他们也不认识渔港的一些活动啊，一些拍卖的一些东西，对，然后才想说可以举办这个，然后不管是给小孩还是亲子之间来参加都很好。
Xiao Tong leads these tours on demand, on top of all her daily tasks. And on certain days, she even follows her dad out to sea.
生垃圾啦，探鱼机无，生垃圾啦，台机的啊，伊个无探鱼，探鱼啊，有鱼啊，无鱼啊，探济啊。
Jin Chiang is semi-retired.To keep his fishing license, he has to operate his fishing boat no less than 60 times a year.
好天我才有出去，啊，歹天确实有风有影，我就无啥爱。因为咱讲个歹听，咱当作伫娱乐个安尼就好。人是爱活咧人生，爱感觉第一快乐。
This family boat, passed down from Chin Chan's father, will soon be retired if no one wants to take over. Chin Chan and his wife both think it's too dangerous for Xiao Tong to be out at sea by herself.
而且大海这样，他不要掉下去，我虽然说会游泳，但我不知道我在海里会不会游。我说你就叫爸爸把绳子绑在船上那里，我就不会掉下去。我掉下去，还有绳子可以把我拉起来。但妈妈还是很担心。对他还是就是拒绝我爸带我出海。
啊，我无去外港，也出来要卖鱼啊，这大生做这大生意。因为毕竟讲起来，每一个人有每一个人的好的兴趣，啊，伊家己要哪做，伊要做的代志，就是爱家己爱要想。
没，你用我那个篮子啊，用大篮子，放这里。好，你来吗？对啊。
我大一的时候去读桃园，就是我想要逃离这里，因为以前小时候是被，就是有种压力被迫来的嘛，所以我想说，我只要搬出去，我只要就是在外面读书，就是我就可以不用帮忙，也不用这么冷了。就是去桃园发现说，我好像恋家的有点严重，我好像有点想家，所以我大二的时候就立马又把它考回来，所以我又回来宜兰读书了。
妈妈一开始，对，还是希望说就是我外面上班啦。爸爸也是觉得说女生做这个不是挺累的，但他也是没有到很明讲说拒绝。是我后面跟他提网络这个，他才听起来好像是稍显比较轻松一点，看起来好像比较轻松，你可以做网络的、啊，然后可能可以多更多方式去卖，他才觉得好，那你就去做吧。但是他也一直说赚没有什么钱。
OK， 干，
哥，
看好不要？
In Jia Shun's case, his parents were completely against his desire to return to the village, but he did it anyway. Jia Shun, whose tribal name is Awi Sapu, is now a key figure in the rejuvenation of the Nan Fong community. Over the years, his conviction to revitalize his hometown has won his mother over. And she now runs Seediq cooking classes for visitors.
现在我要采桑啊，刺葱，然后它等下搭配我们香烤青鱼，然后再来就是我们现在要拿帽。现在我要拿那个三当归，等下会有土鸡三当归汤。这个都是以前我们老祖先留下来的香料，然后现在我们就要到我们的 cooking school 的部落厨房，然后做我们 Seediq 的传统料理。
像我们设计这一餐，也就是因为我们到那个泰国去啊，刚好旅游的时候，他们刚好有一个厨艺教室，我就哎，这个平常我们自己在家做菜哦，这个很平常的事情，怎么让它变成？不平常，
然后因为现在的饮食文化有点西式化，然后我们把传统的料理融入到现代的料理，哦，这个应该就讲是传承的部分。然后就是说，也鼓励我们年轻人回乡之后呢，他们有些做一些料理，简单但是吃起来不简单。小米香蕉糕，
对，
这个已经失传蛮久的一个甜点。
生态的游程呢，我们不是很多人来。那我们思考就是说，我们的那个胃纳量跟承载量，哦，那也不要过度消费地方的资源。
其实上最主要就是要让我们的文化推广出去，然后而且我一直在强调叫传承，哦，希望我们的部落小孩都回来，然后发现我们部落这么美，而且可以创造他们的一个经济效益，让他们愿意留在部落里面，这是我们做长辈的期望。当初嘉勋研究所毕业回来之后，他说他回到部落来做的时候，我很反对。我说你第一个抗压心要够，然后第二个就是说妈妈连袖套都是防弹衣，对。然后我说你可以接受这样的批判吗？然后他 嘉轩就阿伟就跟我讲，他说妈，我所学的我要先留在我的部落，我要让我部落的根扎下去之后，我再去外面去做服务。
Two decades on, Qishan is now the chairman of Nanfeng Communities Development Council, in charge of revitalizing the area's economy and improving the standard of living of the residents. Rural areas in Taiwan account for more than 95% of its land area, but only 30% of the population. The excessive concentration of population in big cities has created a large urban-rural divide. Since 2019, the government has made rural revitalization a top priority. But Qishan thinks there's no need for people to rush into moving to the countryside.
So I often encourage young people, I say, one or two years, you've been hit, it's not a problem. Go out, come back, but at least you have this one or two years of the 哦，当你有好的工具、好的方法，再回到地方都不迟。哦，但是你必须跟地方要有所连接。
For decades, the population in Taiwan's rural areas has been in decline, exacerbating the problem.Is a rapidly aging population caused by one of the world's lowest birth rates. The lack of prospect for the young is emptying out villages. Some have begun to disappear. But efforts by Qishan to bring people back to Nanfeng community are bearing fruits. He is seeing an uptick in the number of youth returning. Shi Chia, or Pawan Neong, is one of them.His family owns a large plot of land by the stream, and for a long time not much was done with it. Together, these men have transformed it into an eco-park for students and visitors.
其实真的就是要让下一代知道我们以前的祖先是如何跟这块土地的连结。所以我们拿弓的时候，我们不能像现代弓拿得太正。为什么？你拉弓的时候，可能箭就会掉下来了。
Camping here, visitors get to experience the Seediq tribe's hunting culture.
Yo, 因为主要就是说我们的猎刀，好，我们的猎刀会藏在我们的披肩底下，所以你们要认真练习哦，好不好？好，来，好哦，哥哥已经射到，如果要讲那个射到的地方，那不是山猪的心脏，山猪的心脏是在低一点，好，好，打到猪屁股，决定要做这个事情的时候。其实很多人是观望的，甚至有很多人是吐槽的。他就讲说：“啊，你们这样做，其实你们跟其他的部落也是一样啊，你们就是要用我们原住民的文化去消费自己，然后去赚钱。”那可是他们殊不知，他们原来他们看到我们开始在经营、开始在做的时候，他们也就开始改观了。来，你们看到这个有没有？好，那边就是山猪挖的，这是真的、啊。这不会是爸爸挖的啊！我们开发游程绝对不是让大家只是来玩，我们更多的是教育。来，你看那边，你看那边，很像挖土机挖的地，他们是用嘴巴，用嘴巴，然后那边不是有獠牙吗？然后去铲土，挖到他们想要吃的东西的时候，他们就会在那边吃。哎，嗯，你们看到前面是什么？
兔子。
兔子啊、哦，爷爷以前就是这样带爸爸去的。哦，然后爷爷。爷爷就以前老人家就跟小孩子讲说，我们要从小的猎物开始抓，加油哦！哦，哇，你这爆头哎！最后的一个目标就是要留给小孩子，那留给小孩子什么？不是留给他们财产，而是留给他们未来要做的事情。 我们家族的文化传承这一块要一直延续下去。
Ecotourism brings in 15,000 visitors to the village every year, giving Nanfong community millions of dollars of additional income. Another business that Chi Chia and other villagers have ventured into in recent years is camellia tree farming.
我们也希望就是说我们还要再给下一代再多一点的时候，那我们就不能再从文化这块去着手了。所以我们才进而才开发，就是去做我们的农特产。
Native to the area, camellia trees have traditionally been planted by the Seediq to prevent landslides, which happen often in this region. But in recent years, oil extracted from camellia seeds has been found to be even more nutritious than olive oil.It's gained popularity as a superfood and is dubbed olive oil from the east. Villagers are capitalizing on these new market opportunities.
种子啊，我小时候有吃过，当它晒干的时候有没有？它的外壳剥掉的时候，它里面会有一个种仁，有没有这个种仁？这个种仁去咬它的时候，前面会带点甜甜。很觉得很好吃，像坚果类，可是当到后面的时候，它是苦苦的。
Rui Yang or Pawan Nomin is another local who's returned to work with villagers to scale up camellia oil production. The 34-year-old with a postgraduate degree in agricultural studies had worked many jobs outside of Nanfong. He had no plans to return until he met Qishan.
当时那时候我们在谈论说。你回来做，把你的专业知识带进来，把你的舞台找回来，然后再就是把你是真的想做的事情留在部落里面。但是我其实我听了感触蛮深的，因为通常没有人会这样跟你讲，通常人会跟你讲说：“哎，大家会来，我们大家聚一聚，我们来赚钱，哦，有赚就分，没有赚大家就散。”
Rui Yang now heads a team of small farmers specialized in growing camellia trees. Their operation has attracted at least 15 more young people to return. He's banking on more to do so.
This is our dried fruit. It was green, it was wrapped. We dried it,把它果皮上的水分抽开的时候，它会打开，让我们比较好剥取。因为我们最主要是要取它里面的种子。要去做榨油。其实老人跟年轻人聚在一起才是一个重点，因为他们环环相扣嘛。今天只有一群老人家长辈在这里的时候，他没有办法把东西传给下一代，必须靠年轻人。他需要去接受这些老的东西跟你新的东西去结合。
Nanfong Community's Camellia Oil.Has even gained international recognition. Villagers are planning to expand their operations to meet global demand for the oil that is expected to grow annually at 9% in the next 5 years. In another fishing village in the coastal county of Yilan, online seafood retailers Yu Tai Ching visit someone whom they credit much for their success. Professor Shou has been their advisor since university days. He's restored a century-old stone house to serve as an event space for Yu Tai Ching.
因为我们做的是渔业，然后大理这个地方也是一个渔村，所以在活动上呢，其实也是蛮好的去衔接的。这个渔港或者是渔业的兴衰这个部分，也可以从活动中介绍给大家，然后也可以在活动中有插入一些食渔教育，然后在中间就是透过食渔教育跟大家说现在的海洋环境啊。资源不够，所以大家应该要怎么样去选购鱼，要怎么去买鱼？那其实也可以在这个地方进行。
那这里的房子啊， 上面用的是黄藤，所以创生第一件事情一定要先有经济行为。那年轻人是必要的。那对于年轻人要怎么吸引他来，我想第一个就是 head， 啊，就从头，从他的 study， 从他的学习里面开始。那第二个就是 hand， 就是从他的手。他今天来跟我来这边做了一趟服务，他动手去做的时候，他就会可能会去改变他的 behavior， 他的行为。那最后再来去影响到他的 heart， 就是他的心态。或许我们训练的100个学生、50个学生会留下一个或两个，那我想这样就够了。
In the past year, Yu Tai Ching's success has enticed a few others to join Yilan's fish trade.
我现在目前找的就是男生，然后强身健体，我觉得他们可以多尝试一些东西，然后不管是抓鱼啊，还是一些 有的没有什么捕网那些技术的那些都可以把它学起来，然后之后如果他们真的想要出来抓鱼，他们就可以学以致用，因为不一定会有人愿意教你。
那谁？早安，早安，叔叔阿姨们，早安。叔，你也来学哈？哇，跟这个老师学就最厉害了啦，这个老师不简单。
这边是我们的南丰的文件站，老人家这里不是只有来接受光环，哦，或是来这边吃饭，他们也可以在这边从事文化传承的工作，哦，所以这个不是只有他们，哦，同侪这种交流以外，年轻人也会来这边学。我们会跟南丰国小我们的国小同学去做，那我们这边老师也可以到那个国小去教。以前他们都说我只传我的孩子女儿，没有，现在不是，现在赶快愿意学的来，哦，所以这边是我们的宝藏库，哦，
部落从外面回来的年轻人也慢慢增多了。为什么？因为他们觉得就是说回到部落其实是有事可以做的，那只不过就是说有没有人去带领他们。那其实家勋回到部落，他其实就是想要用这样的方式，哦，用这样的方式去撼动那个感动其他的年轻人回到部落。
不是因为这笔比较大笔，然后
young people from elsewhere, including urban city centers, are choosing to make this corner of Taiwan's rural hinterlands their home.
有的是公人员考了，或是学校老师进到这边服务。也有留下来，这也很多都是非原民的，最好是嫁进来哦，因为很多都会嫁进来，我蛮需要他们的啦。对啊，其实在这边很多工作都是嫁进来的媳妇特别强，特别厉害。我常跟我的学生讲哦，尤其我是在那个暨南大学的原专班，那我那一堂课是必修课，那很多的老师会告诉他们说，你们是原住民来原专班，然后学了这些哦知识。哦，了解完之后，哦，你要回部落。我大概是我一个老师跟他说，你准备好再回去，你可以先在后面打滚一阵子，所有条件都 OK 了，哦，那你再回部落也不迟，哦，因为我觉得做部落工作是一辈子的事情，哦，就不要随便让人家动摇你的决心就好了。
For new fisherwomen and online fish retailers Yu Tai Chen, their business is gaining momentum. But returns are still modest.
一天应该都有两三个，两三个订单就接两三个，或者是问的人就问的人倒是挺多，就是问说这个是什么鱼，然后这个要怎么用？因为毕竟我们跟其他的冷冻那些鱼种就是不太一样。我们就比较跳痛一点，就是可能今天有什么我才卖什么，你很常就会没货那种。我们自己好像也有给自己说，因为团队能撑过五年，那就代表他已经是个成熟的团队了。对，所以我们给自己的目标就是这五年。我现在最害怕的就是，他们要舍弃他们原先所在处，然后来到宜兰，然后又要在这边租房子，他们的压力更重，然后他们。有没有办法撑下去？是因为，一开始肯定会因为新鲜感决定留下来，然后后面你如果熟悉了之后，你还有没有其他动力让你愿意在这个团队留下来？是，我没有办法去真的去问到他们内心的想法。
3, 2, 1，耶！
来，欢迎光临，请进。
The Youth Banana Team has a more contemplative outlook on the future. Having made Qishan a top tourist destination, they now want people to stay longer through a new residency program.
除了青年返乡，我比较不喜欢这个名词以外，我比较喜欢是。可以说是移动居住啦，这种会比较好，因为返乡有时候也不一定是他的乡嘛，所以当人走到一个情况的时候，他又会回来去面对他的人生。像这些就是哦，他们曾经出去工作，但是后来父母老了，哦需要照顾，他们就回来，而且回来以后，哎，他会发现这个园子，哎，这样很不错啊，所以也不是都没有人接，但是呢，如何让这个香蕉的农业能够有翻转？啊，这个翻转是它还是必须要有劳动的基础，可是它还可以有其他发展的可能。所以我们觉得，你看蕉农可以当一个 rocker 啊，它也不一定是就是只有在种香蕉、啊。所以就是这个职位这件事的打破，然后生活模式的这种多样性，那又适合这个农村的状况。我觉得应该是有机会，但是还需要努力，所以我们就是看到这样的机会，来继续在做这件事情。你是司机，我人客，慢车爬山就豆豆啊坐。你是心肝，也是我的宝贝。你多陪我去来相找。